Came getting ready to bet in action. Remington 700 footprint. Technically, it's a Defiance Classic action, but same. I got the action all wiped down really well and dried. I use 99% isopropyl alcohol. For the front recoil lug, I take my time, make sure all the cuts for the tape are crisp and clean. I put two layers of tape on the bottom and on the front part of the recoil lug. On the sides, I just use one layer. Getting ready to put some modeling clay in the action. You don't want bedding compound to get up inside your action. So, So, put here in the trigger guard. Takes a little while to clean it out, but guarantee it's faster than trying to grind it out with compound in there. I use a pretty heavy duty string to kind of cut this. Just saw it back and forth. That'll get most of it off. Let's see it afterwards. Done doing this, I go back and clean it up. Okay. Some actions have relief holes, so you want to make sure you get those. But for example, this Defiance has a relief hole for the pen here, for the bolt stop remover. Once over a couple places up here. Keep this sealed up, air out of it. I even put it in a larger Ziploc bag. This has been around for years, so that's a long time. All right, wipe it down and get started on the next step, which is shoe polish. So I use Kiwi neutral shoe polish. I'll do a coat, then I'll rub it down, rub it in there, and then I'll do another coat, rub it down, rub it in there, let it sit, and then for any little crevices, I like to take a Q-tip and get down in there with the shoe polish. But don't take much. Rub it on there. And I still put shoe polish over top of the clay I just did. Makes it all the better to pop it out of the action. I've gone through and I've taken out these bolt stop levers, but I end up finding out that the compound never really runs that high. I don't use that much compound, so. Another area you want to make sure you get it in, but we'll do the screws as well, is your receiver holes. Also do up in front of the barrel, even though I don't bed in front of the recoil lug, typically. If it's a very thin barrel, I'll bed up about an inch and a half, but for these normal barrels, this is a 1.20 barrel with an 810 muzzle. Not too heavy, only 22 inches long, so it's not too heavy. All right, let me wipe this down. I don't like to use sprays like Hornady One Shot. I mean, it'll work as a release agent. I'm not saying they don't work. It just, I don't get as smooth of a finish as I do when I use the neutral shoe polish. But, you know, use what works for you. I typically let that one dry a bit. Then I'll get a Q-tip. Make sure I get down in the I put that aside until I get the stock. Try to get this to be as streak free as possible so that way it'll have a nice finish, at least for appearance wise, on the action. It doesn't really change how it shoots. Biggest thing is to not have any voids and bubbles and uneven torque. Just make it stress free. All right. That's it for the action. Okay, this is a Macmillan stock. And I like to take a Dremel and rough the edges up. Just put little bitty divots in it where I'm going to put bedding compound. And then behind the recoil lug, I like to put divots, even just basically all the way around, even on the back side, down in these little teardrop cutouts. Just holds the JB Weld, which is what I use as an epoxy. Holds it pretty tight. I also like to take tape . Put it on the front part of the recoil lug area to where I don't want bedding compound to stay. Make sure no tape goes down in front. I've also wiped this down with alcohol. Make sure it doesn't have any grease or dirt. That'll keep the JB Weld from sticking. Operate. Okay, one thing when I was fitting the action, I noticed that there was an area right here that was a little tight. So I'm going to clean that out, make it a little bit bigger. Get a little bit more space for the JB Weld to sit. Okay. Another thing I like to do is I like to mark the back where the rear tang is going to sit. And I typically don't put JB Weld on that little, let's say a quarter inch up from where the rear tang is going to sit. I like to use this to make sure it sets my height all the way down through. Sometimes can't be helped, but more often than not, JB Weld will squeeze up in there anyway, but it's usually very, very thin. So I try to basically avoid a buildup of JB Weld there. All right, so the next part is taping off the stock. And just double checking everything again and again. And put my screen back in my clay. I don't do it now, I forget. Okay. Clean my hands. Hopefully the tape will stick to the stock and not me. Biggest thing we're doing this is to keep it from running down along the edges, and it makes it really easy to clean. this up in two pieces.
little divot there from McMillan. Don't like how that looks. Again, I don't anticipate JB Wall getting back there, and at least not too much. Like I said, I always clean it out. What I like to do also is take a marker and mark on the tape how far back the tang sits. So that way I know any JB Wall back behind that, back in this area, needs to come out. Matter of fact, usually I stick model and clay in there, but it's kind of a pain. Sometimes I can do it with tape, sometimes I can't. Biggest thing is making sure it doesn't come out past. Okay, now I'm gonna use my shoe polish again. And put it on the tape. So I put the shoe polish on pretty liberally. It's about the only time I like to use that word, liberal. Again, not bedding in front of the recoil lug.
shoe polish along the edge. Still too wet. Again, just putting it on to make sure the JB weld doesn't stick and the sides, and makes for an easier cleanup. I don't really ever mess with this. That's where the safety goes. Since there's no JB compound that goes in there, I don't worry about it overflowing too much, but still put some on the outside. Okay. Some people will use the modeling clay and clog up the whole magazine well and trigger guard well. I don't like to do that. It's kind of a pain. So I just take shoe polish and put it down in there. Now in some actions where it's super rough, lots of fiber showing, it doesn't work. You have to use modeling clay, but on these more custom actions, they are pretty smooth. So and there's some JB weld that goes down in there, but I just take a Dremel at the end and clean her up. Okay, now for the more difficult places to reach, use a Q-tip. I'm careful not to make sure the shoe polish hits any of the areas where the JB well needs to stay to support the action. Another thing about the JB Weld is I just really like the consistency of it, the texture. You usually like to, I find it works best when you get it all mixed up and you give it about, depending on the temperature and humidity, about 10-15 minutes to kind of get to that really good peanut butter consistency. And then you can start applying it. Q-tip starts getting all fuzzy. Time to switch. I've probably done probably over 100 rifles, and this is not the way I used to do it when I first started. I was super paranoid, and it's okay to be a little paranoid. I'm just saying I was a little over the top. But, knock on wood, I've never stuck an action. I had one that was close, and that was the first time I used DevCon. I had to put it in the freezer overnight. And it popped right out, and the next morning I took it out. For example, right now on my list, my to-do list, I have 20 rifles of my own, 18, that I have to bed. Some of them are smaller jobs, like a Savage B-Mag. Okay. So that should allow that to pop out. When JB Weld gets in there, it typically just a little bit of a nudge and it'll pop right out. It's nothing to adhere to. Because the shoe polish is a release agent. Through and clean up the areas that are going to require like to go through and take a mental pause and make sure I'm not forgetting anything or obviously I have it taped up. Everything's been treated with the shoe polish. Ah, I am forgetting something. I like to take shoe polish, put it down the I know I still do the I know I still do the action screws, but I just want to make sure it's not an end all be all. I usually drill these out bigger anyway when I'm done. I think 5/16 is what I drill them out to, I think. Okay. Now. So, one thing I like to do is, even though I don't know, in the last 30 or so, I've never had that much compound to where it leaks out and comes all the way down around the bottom of this, but I still like to spray it down. Just to make sure. Okay. On the home stretch, what I like to do is mix the JB Weld up when I'm almost ready to do this. So that way, gives it time to get to a good consistency. At least the consistency I like. Some people talk about shrinkage and stuff when it comes to the bedding compound, and you know, I don't know what the scientific answer is, but I really don't know how you would measure that in a rifle other than maybe it's shrinking really bad and it starts to come loose and leave marks on the action or in the bedding compound itself in the stock. But I also never keep a gun that long to let something shrink over time. So I just like to use the whole tubes to mix it up. I don't really always use all of it, but it's there in case I do. Now sometimes if I'm doing just the recoil lug, I'll use, you know, half a tube of each, but this time we're doing the whole action. So. I don't know who invented this stuff, but I use it all the time. Getting ready to use it on a fence post tomorrow. Okay. I like to mix it all up. One thing I like to do also is put a little sharper point on these little popsicle sticks. And get down into the edges and helps get rid of any air bubbles. Well, that's setting up. Let's talk about the post I'll be using. So this is for the front and this is for the rear. The rear one was really fat.
and it would hit the back of the trigger guard. So I ground it down. So now I can spin it and it stays straight without kinking because this fat part was hitting the back of the trigger guard. I like to use these threaded posts. With a little, I don't know what kind of nut that is, wing nut. I like to put this in the action and it helps align it as it's coming down through the holes there. So let me get these waxed up. And only they won't stick. Of anything you don't want to stick, you definitely don't want those in there to stick. When I'm doing this stuff, I like to use a spray. Should be just enough sticking out that I can do that. Okay. Lots of Q-tips. Clean this stuff up. I think we're ready. Okay, here we go. I like to put quite a bit in the recoil lug area first. Get it all down in the corners.
I try to avoid the action screw hole there. Sometimes you get some down in there, but that's why we put the shoe polish down in there. I have to put a whole lot on the side. Like I said, I try to put very little, if any, on the back side. Okay, that's pretty good. like to take a Q-tip and come up from underneath to push out any of that excess stuff. Don't worry, it'll go back down in there, but mostly just don't want it to stick. All right. This should do it. Okay, here we go. Again, I like to use this one as a guide. Go in there. I like to let it just kind of sit down in there nice and easy. And I like to work it back and forth a little bit. Push it all the way back. Okay, bottom little one. Okay, so I like to tighten these up just finger tight, just ever so slight. And then back it off just a tad. Make sure it's stress free. There we go. Now, some quick clean up here. Trash can. Sometimes I forget Q-tips have two sides. Some of my Q-tips, the ones with the wood handle, don't. So. See what I mean? I like to use a little CLP the second time around. Some people use DW-40. Yeah, I'm ready to eat, hon.
Okay.
Is it ready now?
Yeah.
All right, give me about 5 minutes. I'm just cleaning up.
Okay.
Thank you. do it. I think that's good. Okay, one little quarter snug. Oh, it's not stress-free. I do not like to use tape on a barrel because, how do I explain this? You may think it's going to be centered, and the barrel may very well end up being centered in the stock. But putting the tape on there and forcing it to line up in the center is actually putting stress on it. So you really just want this thing to sit down in there, just be snug, but still be low enough at the proper height, and let it go. If your barrel and stock don't line up, it's better to, you know, mill out your stock. But again, do what works for you.